You are not the father, but if you are, obviously, you have a decision to make about what role you will play in this child's life.
That's correct.
And if he's not the father, you have some decisions to make. You have to go home and figure out what's going on here and how you got to this point. You both agreed to submit to a DNA test, and we have the results of those tests here today. Juan, do you have the envelope?
Yes, ma'am.
Coming up, the DNA paternity test results are revealed, and Judge Faith rules.
The original reason you filed this lawsuit, which is the $1,500 you say he owes you for the truck. I do think you owe her that money, sir. And I'm going to order you to pay the $1,500. As for your claims for emotional distress, both of you, I have no doubt in my mind that this has been a very emotionally taxing experience for both of you for different reasons. But I'm not going to award money damages to either of you for emotional distress because we have a much larger issue in front of us. That's in the past, but now we're going to talk about the future.
Okay.
Okay. And these results have been provided by DNA Diagnostic Center. The results of the paternity test are the probability of paternity at 99.9%. Mr. Rodriguez, you are the father. And so now we're talking about the fact that the two of you will have a child together. You may not like that, sir. You may think that she did this on purpose, and you may not be happy with it. But at this point, you have to think about what is in the best interest of this child who didn't ask to be born and didn't ask to be brought into this world.
I agree.
And so, with those results in mind, I hope that your behavior going forward, because at this point it's a choice of whether you want to co-parent this child with Miss Bell, and you understand that he is engaged to be married to someone else. So the decisions now should be solely focused on this child that the two of you will have together. How many months are you now?
7.5 months.
So you're coming up on your due date soon. There's an old saying, life is 10% what happens to you, 90% how you handle it. And that's the choice that you have when you leave court today. How are you going to handle this? How are you going to handle it? Because now you have someone else that you're bringing into this world. No child wants to be without their father. So I hope that that's something that you will take into consideration. Yeah, because I've heard you testify, and I saw that you wrote in your papers that this was one of the worst decisions you ever made to get involved with the plaintiff. But now you have a different decision to make. And I just want to say I wish both of you well, and I wish your future child that you are having together well. And I do hope that all of you can have a harmonious relationship with each other and be mature enough to not be selfish and think about yourselves and think about the one truly innocent person who didn't ask to be a part of this. That's what you have to do. And if you're grown up and mature enough to do it, then you'll be okay. Good luck to all of you. Good luck.